freaking guitar player these days.
Pretend I'm not here. Just practice. Just.
All right, fine.
Not long before Thanksgiving 2008, our family moved to the same neighborhood that Veronica, my wife, grew up in. In the spring of 2009, V was on the front porch and she saw an old friend of hers, Julie, walk by. And turns out Julie still lived in the same house that she had grown up in the same neighborhood. We met, you know, and started hanging out with Julie and her husband, Larry, and their son, Michael. When we met Larry, he had stage 4 esophageal cancer. Although he looked healthy at the time, he was significantly smaller and weaker than he was just a few short years ago. Larry and I became friends, despite the fact that we had nothing in common. In spite of our differences, we formed a really good friendship in the brief time that we knew each other. Gotten some fights even, some epic battles. I really grew to respect him and appreciate him as a friend. But unfortunately, in October of 2008, his health took a turn for the worse. In a matter of a few short weeks, his health deteriorated significantly. And on November 28th, 2009, Larry passed away. Michael had to adapt to life without a father. He started a new school after being homeschooled for several years. I watched him during this time adapt to these changes, these life-altering changes that no kid should have to go through. When I read the book, Fat Kid Rules the World by K.L. Going, I knew that he had to read it. So I gave him the book and he really liked it. And then found out that the movie was coming. And so I signed up to bring the movie to St. Louis and asked Michael to help. So he helped me hang up flyers throughout St. Louis. In order to appreciate the story, you have to know what he's gone through in his life. And it's been a lot for a kid. He's come out, I think, on the other side. Stronger and a better person, and he's a better musician.
Faster. Faster.
I can't go any faster.
Faster. Faster.
It's the best side A opening to an album ever.
How did you first hear about the movie?
From you, obviously.
All right, but what? Tell me about the first time I told you about it. What'd you think?
Well, you know, I'd read the book and loved it. So, really,
well, before you read the book. Let's start before you read the book.
Before I read the book, I didn't even know about the movie.
I know,
before I read
but
the book,
but when I told you about it, remember you were over it. You were over it.
No. Yeah, when you told me about it, I initially thought by the title that wasn't going to be the best book in the world. Honestly, but
well,
then,
why? Why not?
I don't know. It was just the name. It has a bit of a weird name. I'll give it that.
Okay. All right.
But I ended up reading it and loved it, obviously.
Well, I tried to give it to you 3 times.
I left it over at your house. I just forgot. I didn't do it on purpose. Anymore.
Twice? You forgot twice?
Yeah, seriously.
Are you sure?
I don't have the best memory, Shannon.
Okay. All right. I'm just checking. All right. So third time you brought it home, you took it home that night. Then what happened?
I ended up finishing it within 2 days. I read, like, the first few pages. I was hooked from then on.
Yeah.
So I really liked it. Like I said, 30 million times already.
Well, what did you like about it?
I grew up without a parent, without one parent. Not really grew up, but you know what I'm saying. Lost a parent. And then my sister hated me, always made fun of me. Glad she's not home, because I can say that without her saying anything.
What's school like for you?
Honestly, it's been a lot better than the last 2 years have.
Yeah.
Just started freshman year, yeah. So. But I noticed I used to get bullied pretty bad in the last 2 years, and it's really stopped.
So in junior high, you were in, you know, 7th and 8th grade, you got bullied.
Yeah.
When people would bully you, what would they do?
Make fun of the way I looked, my weight, just everything about me, really.
And how did you respond?
I honestly didn't really know how to. I got into arguments. kind of often with it, because that was about halfway through 7th grade year. I just got sick of everything.
Yeah.
And started getting into, like, arguments over the minor things like that.
So your freshman year has been better, though?
A lot better.
Why do you think that is?
I've matured a lot more than I was. You should have seen me 7th grade year. Yeah. Well, you did. I knew more back then.
What was it about this story in particular? Like, the way that he dealt with his problems. Was there anything like that?
It was kind of the way that I kept them in, didn't really talk to anybody about them.
Yeah.
Which is...
Kept what in?
All his feelings and stuff. Just all this anger and sadness and all this stuff, but all the people that are being mean to him, all the stuff that's going on in his life. Another thing that I also liked about was that he kind of found a way to let it all out through music.
Yeah.
He played the drums, I really got into guitar right around the same time that all this stuff happened. It seemed like the only way I can get any anger or sadness out was really playing guitar. I used to play for hours straight, like every day afterwards, just because it made me feel better.
Did your dad play guitar?
Didn't play an instrument that I know of, no.
They love music, though.
Yeah. Not necessarily music that I like, yeah. But he still loves music.
Yeah. So when we were trying to get the movie to come to St. Louis, you were pretty excited about, you know, getting it done.
I was really looking forward to the main character.
Yeah, Troy.
Yeah, Troy. Why? Because, well, obviously he's the main character of the book, but yeah. I also kind of wanted to see how he acted to see if it was comparable to the book.
Yeah.
And see if it was kind of comparable, like, me, almost.
Yeah. What did you learn from the book?
Honestly, after I read the book, I started trying harder at a lot of things I was doing, like schoolwork and everything, because really made me realize everything's possible, really. If you don't like something, you can still change it, basically. It's what made me think about, because he wasn't happy with himself at all.
Mm-hmm.
And after he met these people, he started making changes and ended up being happy, basically.
So what kind of changes have you made besides schoolwork?
Well, for one, I started playing guitar a lot more, because I had gone to, like, a time where I really wasn't playing it that much for a few months at a time. But I also started, like, changing my attitude towards everything. Basically, my outlook on life was a bit adjusted from the book and the movie.
What kind of role do you think music's going to play in your life?
Well, I don't know. If I get good enough, who knows where I could be in 10 years.
Yeah.
I could be in a band touring, or I could be living in a box. You never know, really.
Well, but you'd be playing music anyway.
Yeah.
Are those songs that you played earlier, is that based on music you've heard, or is that just you noodling around?
Really just me messing around, honestly.
We had some big help, Kale Going, helped us spread the word, and Max Foisey, who's a local radio personality, also helped us by interviewing Matthew Lillard, the director. And Matthew Lillard helped enormously by lowering our threshold from 54 tickets to 41, which was great. But even so, the day before the deadline, we only had 14 tickets sold out of the 52. And then at the last minute, I came up with the idea of asking people to buy a ticket for Michael. Even if they couldn't come to St. Louis to see the movie, we could meet our goal and Michael would be able to see the film. And people did. Michael and one of his good friends went to see the film and really, really enjoyed it.
And is there anything you want to say to KL Going?
Oh my God. This is also a tough one. Well, for one, I really want to say thanks for the autograph book. That was a really awesome thing that you did.
And what about Matt Lillard, the director?
I hate my life right now.
What?
Because I'm so nervous now. I wasn't nervous until this point.
He's not really here.
Well, obviously.
It's just me. You can just say it to me and then...
Yeah, but he's going to see this.
But not till later. Not till later. You won't look stupid till later,
but
so don't worry.
Listen, can I make a deal with you, though? I get to see it after you edit it, before you put it.
All right.
Make sure it's good.
That's fine.
I don't know what to say. Thank you? Really? I don't know.
What would you like to say to everybody who bought you tickets?
Well, I obviously want to say thank you, because it's a really nice thing to do. And I'm surprised that anybody did it. I mean, because really, without them, I wouldn't have been able to see the movie, and that really meant a lot to me, so. Is there anything else you want me to say?
I'm waiting for you to cry, is what I'm trying to get. I'm trying to get some tears.
I'm going to murder you.
For drama. Come on, just...
Shut up.
Can you pretend to cry?
No.
Just so you're like, come on.
No.
Just cry a little bit. Just squeeze a little sadness juice. Come on. Okay. Last question. So, in the movie, Troy tries alcohol before he's 21. He also hangs around with guys who smoke pot. You're not going to do those things, right?
I don't know. No, I'm not.
Till you're at least 18 on your way to college?
Okay.
All right.
Yes, that's only 4 years off.
So. Yeah, that's only 4 years off. Just make it through high school without doing anything stupid. You'll be fine. You got a good head on your shoulders. You want to play one more song going out? Play the most complicated thing you can think of. Challenge yourself right now. Let's see some finger work. Cool. Well, thank you very much, Michael Lux, for rocking the world.
Well, that's the cheesiest outro ever.
Thank you so much for supporting Michael and for making it so that he could see this film. It means a lot. Thank you.
This is just messing around. That's it.
Don't fuck with the fat kid!